You're part of the rebuttal team, if you will. You've watched the campaign roll its narrative out for the past few days. What do you think?
Listen, both parties try to showcase the best and brightest points and their best surrogates that they can, as well as the principles during these campaigns. A lot of it's aimed at the independent voters on TV, but a lot of it's of enthusing the base, too, the people that are there. And so the bottom line in what I see is Bill Clinton gave a great speech. Michelle Obama gave a very personal and good speech, I think, for her husband. President Obama's going to give a wonderful speech tonight. He's very good. But here's at the end of the day, this is what matters. Monday, we had the announcement gas prices doubled, and we had our highest Labor Day prices in the history of the country. Tuesday, national debt hit $16 trillion, the highest in American history, $6 trillion under this president. When the speeches are done tonight, tomorrow, we're going to get the jobs report, and it's going to show 43 months in a row, over 8% unemployment, 23 million Americans are out of work. So at the end of the day, the speeches are nice, the conventions are nice, the nomination's a formality, but this is a serious election in serious times, and it really comes down to whether or not President Obama's policies have worked. And I think when you look at these numbers, by any real measure, you have to say they haven't worked.
So the campaign seemed to be painting two different visions of America based on perhaps similar experiences that people have undergone over the last couple of years. The Romney campaign says perhaps you're not better off than you were 4 years ago, and the Obama campaign seems to be saying, listen, it is tough, but we inherited a pretty deep mess and we're climbing out of it and things are on a positive trajectory. How do I make sense of that?
The president's right. He didn't create the problem. He's just made it worse. And all you got to do is look at the debt numbers, the job numbers, where he started and where he is now. And President Clinton, team player, did a good job saying we're better off now. Obama's going to say the same thing. We're not. And Americans don't believe it. Every public poll that I've seen lately, anywhere from 52 to 70% say, one, we're not better off. And secondly, we think America's on the wrong track overwhelmingly. So it's a real hard case to make.
Is it inaccurate for the Obama administration to say that these jobs, when you look at how many jobs we were losing month after month compared to what we're making now, I mean, is it inaccurate for them to say we're on this better trajectory?
Yes.
Why?
Because it's not enough jobs. 23 million people unemployed or underemployed, more than that, that have given up looking for a job. That's just an unacceptable number. No matter how you cut it, yes, we've created some jobs, but it's woefully inadequate. We're at the lowest number of entrepreneurs, new business startups in 30 years. Why? Because if you ask small business people, it's the tax and regulatory policies of this administration, the honestly anti-business and in some ways anti-free enterprise approach. The president came to Roanoke and said, you know, if you built a business, you really didn't make that happen. Somebody else made that happen. And that's just, that is not resonating with entrepreneurs around the country.
You know, that leads me to ask about that particular we built that or you built that. That phrase has become such a central theme. I saw it in Tampa playing over and over again. When you see the rest of the speech in context, it doesn't seem like that's what he was saying. But it seems to be that's what the Republicans are riding on, is essentially a speech a bit out of context. Is that, this leads me to this larger question of the next 60 days, how am I going to be able to believe anything either side says on these TV commercials that I'm going to be inundated with, especially in a battleground state like Virginia?
And that's a fair question. I think people have to say, first of all, look at the results. Because when you strip it all away, talk really is cheap. I know that from Virginia. People just want to have results. You know, we've balanced the budget without raising taxes. Our unemployment rate now is the lowest in 3 years. We've tried to actually produce things with Republicans and Democrats, shared credit, shared policies, and we're getting things done. It's just not true at the federal level. We've got more combat, more divisiveness, more of a toxic political atmosphere in Washington, less actual results. We've been pushed to the brink of bankruptcy about three times in the last couple of years. I think the president hasn't led.
One of these other narratives that I've kept hearing consistently over the past couple of nights is that the Republicans are waging a war on women. You heard it from different women's rights groups. You heard it from Lilly Ledbetter when it comes to pay equity. How does Mitt Romney combat that, and how does he advance his position and what kind of a president he would be for women?
Well, first of all, it's a contrived argument. You know, if you have a lousy record, if your unemployment rate is 8% for 43 months and your debt is the highest in American history and gas prices have doubled and college tuition is up 25% and your disposable income in the American household is down $4,000 bucks, of course, you're going to change the subject. And the subject is Mitt Romney's tax returns, Bain Capital, a war on women that doesn't exist. And you know what? Women aren't buying it either, because they care about security for their kids. They care about getting a job. They care about reducing the debt for their future. They care about lower gas prices and lower energy prices. And that's why the most recent polls actually have the president's disapproval rating actually higher among women than it was just a couple of months ago. It's just not working.
Thanks for your time, Governor.
Thank you.